Before I start, if you're new here and enjoy the video, be sure to subscribe for more NBA content like this. I'm trying to hit 10,000 subscribers and we are so close to that goal, so I really appreciate all the support you can give. Be sure to leave a like as well if you do enjoy, it really does go a long way. The Golden State Warriors were one of the more disappointing teams this season, but it wasn't really their fault due to injuries to both the Splash Bros and overall having a very young and inexperienced squad. They made some questionable trades as well at the deadline, so it really raises the question, what do the Warriors do to return to contention? What should they do this offseason in order to become title contenders again? In today's video, I will be going over what moves and decisions the Warriors should make this offseason in order for them to return as a favorite next season. Again, if you're new and enjoy the video, be sure to subscribe to help me hit 10k, but with that all being said, let's talk about the Golden State Warriors. The Warriors had, overall, a disappointing 2020 season. Before the year started, many expected them to at least be a playoff contender, but due to factors out of their control, they finished the season as the worst team in the league by a record, with 15 wins and 50 losses. So, what caused this lackluster season? What players have underperformed? The first player was Steph Curry, and whilst obviously he didn't underperform, his absence from the team for most of the season definitely had an impact. Curry still wasn't great statistically this season as well, shooting very poorly from the field and three, and he also averaged a mediocre 20 points a game. Overall, this just wasn't Curry's year. Injuries really set him back, so we can't blame him for the poor year overall, but again, his absence definitely did have a negative impact on the Warriors this year. Having Klay out for the year also didn't help any matters. When the Warriors have a healthy backcourt of Steph and Klay, they have the most unstoppable backcourt in the league, and obviously having him out won't do any good to their success. A player that was actually disappointing this year was Draymond Green. Draymond just did not look like himself at all this season and was simply terrible for most of it. Green averaged a triple single of 8 points, 6 rebounds and 6 assists this season, which is similar to last season, but this year he shot worse overall, having an incredibly inefficient effective field goal percentage of 46%. That's just not good at all, and as someone who was meant to be a leader for this young team, Draymond really failed to meet expectations this year. Good news is that in an interview, Draymond said he's going to try to return to his best self next year, so if it becomes true, the core guys of the Warriors could be very deadly next season. However, it's obvious that Draymond wasn't as good as he should have been this year, and in my eyes, let the team down a bit. Another reason why I think the Warriors were disappointing this year was, apart from their injuries, their roster was quite weak apart from their star players. Players like Damian Lee, Eric Pascal, Jordan Poole, Alan Smilegit, etc., whilst they aren't terrible, they definitely aren't players I'd first consider using to build around my superstars, and we were shown just how poor these guys were this season. Obviously, having a weak roster will cause the Warriors to lose to better teams, so this is another reason why they were so bad this year. So those are the reasons why I believe the Warriors didn't live up to expectations this year. Let me know if you agree with that below, but with that all being said, what should the Warriors do this offseason in order to ensure this season doesn't happen again? How do they climb back up to the top of the West? For the most part, I think the Warriors should just run it back, but there are a couple of moves I'd like to see them try make. The first is trading their draft pick. Since the Warriors were just plain awful for most of the season, they finished with the worst record in the NBA, meaning it's very likely they get a top 3 pick minimum. This pick is going to be very valuable, so they can use this as trade bait with other teams. at this point. I'm not sure who they'd target right now. A report came out the other day saying that they may trade their pick for Jonas Valanciunas, but I feel like they could use that pick to trade for a better star player to come join Curry and Klay. To me, getting a star from trading this pick would be the dream scenario. In my eyes, Wiggins would need to be moved as well, probably in a deal with the draft pick too. In my opinion, he just doesn't fit well in the Warriors system at all. I know the Warriors said they'd keep him, but they said the same with D'Lo, and look what happened. So anything can happen really. Let's not think Wiggins is untouchable. Wiggins to me just isn't very valuable and won't be a big part of this team, so if the Warriors can move him for someone far more useful to their system, I think they should pull the trigger on a deal like that instantly. But let's just say the Warriors decide to keep their pick. I think the best decision for their franchise is to draft a player in the upcoming draft. If that's the case, who should they select? In my opinion, they go for either of these three players: James Wiseman, Anthony Edwards, or LaMelo Ball. In my opinion, Wiseman fits best in Golden State. The Warriors need a center, and Anthony is probably the safest bet in this draft class as well. Anthony Edwards, however, is probably the best player in the draft, and if they get the number one pick, this might be the smartest decision to make, even though Golden State don't need another guard. I also think LaMelo Ball would be a nice selection, though again, they don't need any more guards. I think LaMelo would learn a lot behind Curry and Klay, and in my opinion, he has the highest ceiling in the draft, so if he's the next best player available, I think the Warriors should take him. If the Warriors management truly thinks this dynasty is over, they may want to bet on the future, so drafting a guy like LaMelo Ball would be smart here. Overall, I think this comes down to what pick the Warriors get. If they get the first pick, then Edwards or Wiseman should be taken. If they get second or lower, I think who they choose will heavily depend on who's available and who just got selected. In my eyes, any player here would be a good selection for the Warriors, and I wouldn't be mad at all if they selected one of these three guys on draft night. Overall, this is what I believe the Warriors should do next. For the most part, I think running it back is the best option, as due to injuries, this team hasn't actually even seen their full potential on display yet. We know just how deadly a backcourt of a healthy Klay and Curry is, and with Draymond saying he'll return to his best self in 2021, I'm very excited to see the current core play out. However, the surrounding players definitely aren't up to scratch for a contending team, so I think a trade for another star or pieces to add to their depth could be a move for the Warriors to make this offseason. They should use their potential top 3 pick to secure that star and also move Wiggins in the process, as in my opinion, he doesn't really fit with Golden State. However, if the Warriors fail to make a trade or don't decide to move their pick, I think they should draft either James Wiseman with their pick or Anthony Edwards, and I think LaMelo Ball would be a solid option too. It really depends on what pick they get. That will decide what player they draft in my eyes. The Warriors have struggled this season, that's for sure, but I'm very excited for them and I'm confident they will bounce back next year. With a healthy roster, they are one of the best teams in the league without question, so I wouldn't forget about them this offseason when talking about 2021 contenders. The Warriors always seem to find a way, and I have a feeling they'll do it again this offseason. And that will conclude the video. What do you guys think of this? What should the Warriors do next in your opinion? Are there any trades you guys have in mind? Let me know all your thoughts down in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to drop it a like and subscribe. But with that being said, I am out. Peace.